Researchers from Stanford University have recently announced the successful test of an underwater robot called OceanOneK. Developed by the Stanford Robotics Lab team, OceanOneK, an underwater robot with human-like touch, vision, and interactivity, successfully explored a shipwreck hundreds of meters below the ocean waves. OceanOneK has a humanoid upper half and a thinner back half with 8 multi-directional thrusters that allow careful maneuvering underwater. The robot's haptic feedback technology and stereoscopic vision are able to generate amazingly lifelike sensations for remote users that can only be rivaled by actually diving down to a site yourself. OceanOneK's objective is to explore uncharted depths and show that human touch, vision, and engagement can be conveyed to remote sites. OceanOneK has had many adventures and successes throughout its recent multi-stop trips around the Mediterranean, but the team's overriding accomplishment was the recent fully functional autonomy of the drone at a depth of nearly 3,281 feet. February's dive to the sunken wreck of the sunken Italian steamship Le Francesco Crispi was part of OceanOneK's multi-stop tour of the Mediterranean, which began in September 2021 with 2 trips near Marseille to a World War II P-38 Lightning aircraft and a submarine, Le Petit, that lies at roughly 400-foot depth. The third was a 2nd-century Roman ship in Illyria, Corsica, at a depth of 1,100 feet. The team then headed to Cannes in search of better weather conditions. There, the robot's boom camera viewed inside a 200-foot depth Beechcraft Baron FGDPV cockpit. The final dive was to 852 meter, or over a half mile, where the crew found the robot unable to ascend. OceanOneK was fully functional, however, the flotations around the communication and power cable had collapsed, pinning the connection to the robot. They continued diving after pulling in the slack. OceanOneK's journey to 1 kilometer took years. It began with endless hours of design, experimentation, and assembly in the lab, dozens of trips to the Stanford pool for debugging, and myriad lessons to be learned before addressing the real world. Her predecessor, OceanOne, was designed to reach a maximum of 200 meters. To bring the robot deeper, researchers altered its body with a unique foam made of glass microspheres that offer buoyancy and can resist 100 times the pressure at sea level. The robot's arms are filled with oil and springs that compress the oil to meet outside pressure, preventing collapse and cushioning the electronics. Researchers upgraded OceanOne's microscopic components to reduce the quantity of compressible air in each element and keep it compact. OceanOneK had 2 new types of hands, one produced by Mark Kutkowski's team at Stanford and one by Professor Antonio Bici of the University of Pisa and IIT. Following several months of refinement and testing, the team received a second chance to dive the Roman ship and the Crispi this summer. The team first sought to rescue an oil lamp from the Roman ship but failed. A boom camera arm malfunctioned at the Crispi in February. July dives went smoothly. OceanOneK drove again to the Roman ship under the team's archaeologist's instruction and hauled up several Roman vases, including several not previously seen in Drazim's collections. These extraordinary findings still bore the manufacturer's name and label, demonstrating the benefits of super deep artifact recovery. The OceanOne project combines breakthrough innovations in haptics, underwater robotics, and human-robot interaction with new marine science and underwater engineering prospects, such as inspecting and repairing boats, bridge piers, and submerged pipelines. OceanOneK plans excursions to vanished towns in deep lakes, coral reefs, and archaeologically significant wrecks at depths beyond human grasp.